pride myself with keeping up with current trends, and I tell my students that not only do they need to learn the subject matter for their degrees, they need to master the art of relationships. When we hosted Janelle Monae for commencement, and people asked how I did that there, it's easy. Relationships. I can't recall when I got turned on to this show on HBO, I think y'all may have heard of, called Insecure. The first season I heard people on campus talking about it, and I saw things on social media, and people were really talking about the show and this star, this Stanford-educated dynamo named Issa Rae. Hey.
From New Orleans, who's in the front row. But yeah, I mean, I don't know what else to say about that.
I think part of the interesting thing for me in the times that we live in, for you just to talk a little bit about your experience as a student at Stanford, majoring in African American Studies. What was that like? You know, there's a lot of conversation about what's happening on college campuses. What was your college years like, and how did that sort of form who you would become as a person that you are?
Because a lot of people at that school in particular were mostly into, you know, they were pursuing medicine, they were pursuing law, and they were pursuing engineering. Nobody was really pursuing the arts in that way. You know, there were clubs here and there, and the drama department was okay. But it really allowed me to stand out because that was something that I was really, really passionate about.
When did you realize that you had this gift that, I mean, when you sort of steered, you have like this epiphany to be like, I got something special here that this is really going to happen. Something big is about to happen with me. Did you have that kind of moment where you sort of knew like, I'm about to blow up?
No. I think, you know, there were several moments early on in college. I was 19, and I was like, I'm about to get an Oscar. I had an age of 21. Didn't have a script, didn't even do work, but it was just like, I know it's about to happen, it's gonna go down. And it was just like, what are you talking about? And I was constantly competitive and just against people that I just wasn't even in the same league in because I wasn't doing the work. And for me, I had these unrealistic expectations. And I was very impatient. I mean, I'm still a very impatient, impulsive person. Like, if I want to do something, I'll do it, and I'll think about the consequences later.
God, all you people get here real early and stay outside and wait till, if you be here tomorrow, this could be out there waiting for you. What is it about this show?
Well, first of all, I have to clarify that interview that you saw, the headline was from Rolling Stone, and they were like, they tried to Lauryn Hill me, and they were like, this show says Insecure is not for white people or for guys. And I said, and creating the show, they weren't who I was thinking about my family and friends. And yeah, when I think about that, that's true. Like I didn't say, ooh, what kind of show can I make for white people? For dudes. It was really just like, what will my friends laugh at and what will my family laugh at? And I think people are responding to just, we're telling specific stories and it's from a very specific point of view. And at the same time, you know, just given the fact that we're all human and there's a diverse writer's room, from all different backgrounds telling their stories, and we're funneling those stories through Molly and Issa. I think people are just responding to the fact that it feels real, and we've all been through, you know, on some scale, some of those situations. And it's about relationships, it's about friendship. Everybody's had a friend, everybody's had a relationship, everybody's had a crush, you know, of some sort, and everybody's, if you're lucky, has had a job, and it's those kind. So I think we're just telling, we're not doing anything revolutionary, but this is the first time where you really get to see, in a long time, I should say, because I was influenced by regular black people in the 90s, but since then we just haven't had a chance to just be, and I think, you know, you're seeing black people contemplating, you're seeing them in the mirror, you're seeing them loving each other, you're seeing them make love, you're seeing them hate each other, curse each other out, and it's just like, in a way that, you know, I with my friends or boyfriend or, you know, whatever. So I think people are just responding to authentic stories.
Like, that was an issue. How did you perceive that? And I mean, make this that people like, we think just so social responsible as well. How did you process that? Because we watch so many shows, but that's not even, nobody raises that as an issue. So I thought that was weird for me.
I was like, yeah, we're gonna do it. And then you know, we got an earlier date, and while we wanted to do it, we had different ones. They didn't see some home. We put condoms in the background, we put them on, you know, a nightstand and things like that. And did it, we were just like, people, this should be assumed. And so I think this time around, you know, we still had condoms in the background. We had a whole episode showing that these girls are doing condoms. But I think for me, I wanted to respond because I'm like, if it's taking people out of the story, then that's a problem. Because if you're focusing on the fact that they didn't put on a condom and you're missing this moment that we set up that's going to pay off later, then we should have
done it. Okay, so my question to you is, as a successful Black woman, you know, you're writing, you're starring in your show, what advice would you give about doing it yourself?
My advice would be to look next to you and partner with people who are equally as focused and as passionate as you are.
How was that transition going from a web audience to television? And was there pressure to kind of like regurgitate the ABG storyline to TV?
I think the transition has been great because doing the web series, you're taking on so much. Like, all I wanted to do was just write a show. I didn't want to be in it. I want my homegirl to be in it, but she was in DC and I was in LA. I can do this. And so you're wearing the acting hat, you're wearing the producing hat, you're wearing the directing hat, you're wearing the editing hat, you're wearing the catering hat, you're giving people rides, like that, there's just so much that you're doing just to get the show done.
So Issa's about to leave the stage, so before she goes, I want y'all to give her, we can give her like an awesome round of applause.